everyone. In today's tutorial, we will be walking through the latest advancements for the Twinmotion to Unreal Engine workflow. For those who may have used the plugin in the past, we will be covering the latest developments for the plugin in conjunction with the release of Twinmotion 2021. Here I have a Twinmotion 2021 file that is ready to go into Unreal. To do this, I'll pull up the Epic Games Launcher, go up to the Marketplace tab at the top, and I'm going to go into the Search Products tab, and I'll type in Twinmotion. You'll see that a couple of plugins pop up. We will need to download the Datasmith Twinmotion Importer and Twinmotion content for Unreal Engine. If this is your first time downloading the free plugin, you may need to first add it to the cart and go through the purchase workflow. You'll see I have already done this, in which it says owned. I'll now click on this plugin, and you'll see that there's some additional information you can find here, such as a forum and a survey, so that we may better understand your experience with the plugin. There's also a document with the instructions for installation, as well as the release notes to let you know the latest advancements and limitations. I'll now go back up and hit Install to Engine. We'll be looking for this 4.26. I'm going to hit Install. Now the plugin supports Unreal Engine 4.26.1 and up for Windows and macOS. Files from Twinmotion 2021.1 and 2020.2 will be compatible. Files that were saved from previous versions of Twinmotion may not load properly in Unreal. In order for Unreal to read all of the data and assets from Twinmotion, it'll need to have access to all of the libraries, so this plugin might take some time to download. Once completed, I'll go back into the Marketplace and install the other plugin as well. Now that we have both of the plugins installed, I'm going to launch Unreal Engine 4.26. I can now start a new project. I'll go to the Architecture category, hit Next, and then I'm going to select the ArcFIS template as it's a great starting place for those new to Unreal. I'm going to include the starter content so I can pull any existing material, and I'll enable ray tracing here. And then type in my project name. So now that the template is pulled up, I'm actually going to go ahead and delete some of these things so that we can bring in our project. If you are new to Unreal, you may want to keep these notes in and take a look, but if not, you can go ahead and delete them by selecting the notes down to the terrain of this sample geometry here in that world outliner window on the right hand side. I'll go ahead and right select that, go edit, delete, and then I'm going to enable the plugins for Twinmotion. To do that, you can go up to Edit on the top left-hand side, select Plugins, and then I'm going to type in Twinmotion. You'll see that two different plugins pop up. If you have worked previously with this plugin, you may have downloaded three different plugins. We have been able to condense them to two, so I'd encourage you to re-download these two so that they are the most up-to-date and compatible with Twinmotion 2021. So the first one, this Datasmith Twinmotion Importer, will contain the mechanics for transferring the Twinmotion file into a Datasmith file. If you are not familiar with Datasmith, it brings entire complex scenes into Unreal without the need of reconstructing the project. It supports a wide variety of file formats, including SketchUp and 3ds Max, and it now supports Twinmotion. The ecosystem within Datasmith is vast, and the technology will continue to improve with more intelligent data preparation and maximum runtime performance. So I'll go ahead and enable that. A window will pop up letting you know that this is still in beta. I'll go ahead and hit yes. And then the Twinmotion content. This plugin is going to be the plugin that houses all of the Twinmotion library assets. This essentially means that even if you are not bringing a Twinmotion native file, that you have the ability to import the Twinmotion assets by enabling this plugin. Once selected, you will need to restart your file. So I'll go ahead and hit Restart Now, and then Save Selected. So now they should be accurately installed, and I can close out of this window here. And now let's bring in the model. So I'm going to go to this Datasmith button at the top, and I'm going to navigate to the Twinmotion file. If you're familiar with other Datasmith workflows in Unreal, you may be used to exporting a project as a Datasmith file. With this plugin for Twinmotion, you'll be able to bring in the Twinmotion file as is. So I'll go ahead and select this and hit open. A dialog box is going to pop up for all of the geometry that you would like to bring into Unreal. I'm going to go ahead and put it into the content folder here, hit OK. And then I'm going to keep these settings as in and bring in everything. I'm going to go ahead and hit the drop-down button here and take a look at the static mesh options. You'll see that there are some light map settings here. I do want to point out that light peaking in Unreal requires well-defined light map UV coordinates. Twinmotion does not rely on light mapping to calculate global illumination, and therefore that information is not present in Unreal. This can be mitigated with some Unreal tools for automatically generating unwrapped UVs. However, I will stick with these settings and use ray tracing, which I enabled at the start of the file. So if you are familiar with the light baking workflow in Unreal, please be aware it may be different when bringing in a Twinmotion file. I'll go ahead and hit import. Now this may take some time depending on how large your file is. You'll see that a message log window popped up. If you get load errors after the import, it's most likely due to it being saved in a release version prior to 2021.1. Working with the latest Twinmotion release should remove these error messages. You'll see that I still have some here. This is because I had a few mesh assets that are not yet compatible in Unreal. It's going to include the car and then the animated group that has these assets as accessories. I'll go ahead and close out of this tab. Now let's take a look at the model in Unreal. You'll see that the trees came in quite nicely. Now the sculpted landscape will not import properly, but you'll see that I do have a surface here that I applied a material to as the landscape. Now to get a better look at our project, I'm going to switch into a camera that came in from my Twinmotion file. So if I go up to the perspective tab on the top left-hand side, you'll see that there are three placed cameras here. These are going to be the cameras that came with the template. And then we have these stadium still cameras that came from Twinmotion. You'll notice that the name, position, direction, aspect ratio, and focal information are all imported. Any visual effects, lighting changes, or exposures that were specific to the camera are not retained. So you'll be needing to set those up with a post-process volume in Unreal. Now I'm going to go to the right-hand side and take a look at the hierarchy in the World Outliner window. You'll notice that the geometry is translated as static meshes. It's the same as the scene graph in Twinmotion, resulting in a combination of actors and mesh components. So I had these folders, the decals folder, an entourage folder, and exterior props, that come in with the same hierarchy in Unreal. Now I'm going to switch to a different camera to take a look around. The starting ground and context are imported into the project, so you'll see I have the context here. You'll also see that all the decals came in quite nicely. I can hit G on the keyboard to toggle the icons off and on. To rotate, I'm using the mouse buttons. Right or left will allow you to move through the project. You can also use WASD when you have the mouse buttons pressed. So you can see that the ready pose character came in here. It looks quite nice. And I'm also going to take a look at one of the animals. You'll see that I have this pigeon here. I'm going to select it and hit F on my keyboard, and it zooms into the object I have selected. Now you can see that there's a depth of field on this camera, and perhaps I want to change that a bit. So I can go into the World Outliner tab on the right-hand side, and I'm going to select the camera that I'm using in the viewport, and I'm going to scroll down in the Details panel below to find the focus settings. So I'm going to hit the drop down here, and then hit this eyedropper button next to the manual focus distance. And I'm going to select the wall in front of it. So you'll see that the pigeon comes into view. And I'm going to up my aperture here as well. So now let's take a look at this animal. Animals are partially imported. You'll see that the materials are assigned to the skeletal mesh on the right-hand side, but they don't have the animation data linked. So we'll need to do that here. I'm going to go ahead and hit this magnifying glass underneath the SK pigeon, and you'll see that all of the relative assets for this pigeon pop up. You have the skeletal mesh, and then the animation is what you need to link to it. So it's going to be the AN pigeon with the green bar at the bottom, And to bring it in, you will need to go back to the details panel on the right-hand side. And underneath animation, you'll look for the animation mode, hit the drop-down, and select Use Animation Asset. I'll then go back to the pigeon, drag and drop that in the animation to play. So you'll notice that nothing actually happened just yet, but we can go into the top, and next to where it says play, there's a drop-down button. You can select that and hit simulate, and you'll notice that the pigeon comes to life. Now I'm gonna get out of the simulation and take a look at some of the geometry. If I select one of these elements and take a look at the materials and the assets, you'll see that it comes in really nicely. I'm also gonna take a look at the model itself that I brought in from another modeling software and take a look at the information in the details panel. When I scroll down, you'll see that there is a tags section. When I open this up, there's going to be a Twinmotion resource ID applied to it, which could be helpful for visual data prep. I'll keep scrolling down and go to the asset user data. So I'm on the bottom right-hand side down here, and I'm gonna keep on hitting these dropdowns. You'll see that there's a Datasmith user data. When I click on that, it's gonna have a metadata option here. So if you are using BIM for your project and have a lot of metadata in there, it will be supported in Unreal. Now let's take a look at the lighting. So all Twinmotion lights are converted into Unreal lights. The name, position, shape, size, IES profile, intensity, and color are imported. However, information such as haze amount, shadow casting distance, and other visual effects that are applied to lights are not included in the import. So I went ahead and brought in one of these lights. Let's go find it. There we go. If I hit F, it will zoom in. Now you'll notice that it's not showing up in the project at all. This is because the exposure between your Twinmotion file and your Unreal file may not be the same. So I would go in and first set my exposure in Unreal to be accurate and then go in and coordinate the lights to best fit the exposure. We don't have time to go into that aspect today, but there is a Twinmotion webinar that covers this in detail. I'll go down to the right-hand side. I'm gonna bump that number up for intensity just so we can take a look at it. You'll see that you have the other settings in Unreal that you had in Twinmotion, such as the attenuation radius and the cone angles as well. You also have access to temperatures and a wide variety of options here. Now, one of the most exciting aspects of the plugin that we would like to point out is the Twinmotion asset library. So let me showcase that now. If I go into the bottom right section of the content browser, you'll see that there are view options and a drop-down button. I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna make sure that this show plugin content is enabled. I'll then go over to the left-hand side and hit the source panel button. And you'll see that the pigeon folder popped up because I had used it to bring in the animation. And you'll notice that all of the other animals are here as well. I can then go into a ready pose folder and you'll see that all of the assets for the ready pose characters are here. So we can drag and drop one of the characters into the Twinmotion file. Now this can be very helpful for anyone working in Unreal who wants to bring in any of the Twinmotion assets that are static meshes. So I can drag and drop him in, rotate, scale as needed, and then I could continue working and placing characters in the scene. You'll notice that you have access to the cutouts as well as the materials. It's all going to be underneath this Twinmotion to Unreal content. Now, this is a great starting point for developing your project in Unreal. As I mentioned, there is a Twinmotion webinar that goes a little more in depth into the settings of your Unreal file. If you want to learn more about Unreal, if this is something that's new to you, there are beginner classes as well as more advanced classes on the Unreal Online Learning Portal system that you could check out. This is all we have for today. Thank you for joining.